Good morning to you. It's good to see you today as we worship our Creator together. So many different things that we're thankful for, and I think that's where we need to focus today. And just the thanksgiving that we have. We have an opportunity here in this church to take up a special offering, and we're doing it for the next couple of weeks. You heard about it last week, and you heard about it the week before. One of the things we're doing is helping to provide Christmas. Our goal is for at least 1,000 children in Guatemala. Because of the cost there, for $5, our missionary that we support, David Stroh, can buy gifts, soccer balls, and all kinds of things for kids. And so we're trying to support that. And what we want to be able to do is, here in just a moment, you're going to see a video of what that can do and what that can accomplish. Following that video, we'll have an opportunity to stand together and pray as a community of faith. Again, is how blessed we are. If you don't already know, David Stroh was here last year at our Thanksgiving dinner. David Stroh actually took his family there, moved down there about 8 months ago, and as a result, I mean, he's got 11 of his kids living with him there. And because they minister in an area that was away from where they were living, they actually just recently moved. And she gave up the washer and the dryer and things like that. I don't even think they have a shower anymore. And I can only imagine just the ordeal of washing clothes and taking a bath. Yet for so many people, I don't care where they're from, for so many people, that's something they can't even comprehend. We are blessed. I cannot emphasize that enough. We are blessed. You know, we're struggling. We get upset because we don't know what color shirt to put on. Really? We're blessed. You know, we are blessed. And I hope that you are able to recognize the thanksgiving that we should have for the greatness of who Jesus is. You pray with me. God, as we come before you today, we do recognize that we are blessed. We're unworthy, but yet you have just shown us the grace and the mercy and the love that you have for us. And we, God, we come before you today. I pray everybody in this room come together to acknowledge the splendor of knowing God, declaring that you are the King of Kings, declaring that you are the Redeemer. We're so grateful. God, for tonight, I pray for those who are coming to our Thanksgiving dinner simply because I believe that there are so many coming who have not acknowledged you as Savior. And so, God, may we very clearly speak those words about what it is to know Jesus. But, God, I think probably more importantly, may we demonstrate it in our willingness to go and to meet new people and to engage them and just to love them no matter what. God, may we step out of our comfort zone. May we refuse, just as that song said, may we refuse to stand by claiming to have eternal life through you while others around us perish. May we refuse. God, I think about others who are struggling so much, and I think about Peter still. I think about how much he is struggling with his own physical health and the difficulties there. But I think also about others who this Thanksgiving, maybe they're struggling because maybe they're going to be without family or friends. Lord, may we refuse to let that happen. May we reach our hands out to them. We love you and we thank you for all that you've done. In the name of Jesus, amen.